Hello everyone, today we are going to see the first chapter in geography, which is the Earth and the Solar System. We have already seen about the following topics like the Solar System. Under this we have Mercury, Venus and Earth in part 2. Synopsis of the lesson. In this session we are going to see the following topics. The first one is Earth, a unique planet, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. We have other celestial bodies like moons, asteroids, meteoroids and comets. Now we are going to see the first topic, that is Earth, a unique planet. So what is mean by unique? Unique means special. So Earth, a special planet. Earth is the only planet in the solar system where life exists. Here exist means live. It has water, land and air. It is favorable to sustain life. Here sustain means strengthen life. As it is not too cold and not too hot. Presence of various gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen in its atmosphere support life. So, in Earth, there is a presence of various gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen in its atmosphere that supports life. Next, let's see about Mars. Here we can see the picture of Mars. This is the fourth planet from the Sun. So Mars is the fourth planet from the Sun. It is also called the red planet. Why it is called as red planet? Why? Because due to the large presence of red oxides in its soil. That's why Mars is also called the red planet. It revolves around the Sun in 687 days. Here revolves means move in a circle. So Mars moves in a circle around the Sun in 687 days. It has two satellites or moons revolving around it. Here revolving means move in a circle. It spins on its axis in one day. Here spins means rotate or go round. So it rotates on its axis. Axis means center line in one day. Next we are going to learn about asteroid belt. The above mentioned four planets are made of rocks and are called the inner planets. So the above mentioned four planets like Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars are made of rocks and are called the inner planets. Beyond these four planets there is a ring of asteroids which are like smaller rocks and stones moving around. This is also known as the asteroid belt. So in this picture we can see the picture of asteroid belt. Beyond the belt are four more planets which are known as the outer planets. So the outer planets like Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. These are very far and are made of liquids and gas. Here we can see the picture of inner planets and outer planets. Inner planets like Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars. Outer planets like Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Next, we are going to learn about Jupiter. Here we can see the picture of Jupiter. Jupiter is the fifth planet from the Sun. and the largest planet of the solar system. It takes 11 years and 11 months to revolve. Revolve means move in a circle around the sun, but its own rotational speed is the fastest. It finishes one complete rotation in 9 hours and 56 minutes, or nearly 10 hours. It has 16 satellites or moons revolving around it. Revolving means move in a circle around it. Next, let's see about Saturn. Here we can see the picture of Saturn. This is the sixth planet from the sun. So Saturn is the sixth planet from the sun and is the second largest planet of the solar system. It has rings around it, and this makes it one of the distinct means clear and beautiful planet of the solar system, which can be seen through a telescope. So here we can see the picture of Saturn with rings. The rings are made of dust, rocks and ice. It revolves around the sun in 29 years and 5 months. Here revolves means move in a circle on its own axis. Here axis means center line. It rotates at a high speed of 10 hours and 40 minutes. It has over 30 satellites or moons. Next, we are going to learn about Uranus. Here we can see the picture of Uranus. This is the seventh planet from the sun. So Uranus is the seventh planet from the sun. It is the third largest planet of the solar system. This also has a ring around it. So in this picture, we can see the picture of Uranus with a ring. It orbits around the sun in 84 years. On its axis, it rotates in 17 hours and 14 minutes. It has 17 satellites or moons revolving around it. Revolving means move in a circle around it. Do you know only two planets, that is Venus and Uranus, rotate on their axis from east to west, and all other planets from west to east? Next, let's see about Neptune. Here we can see the picture of Neptune. This is the eighth and furthest planet of the solar system. So Neptune is the eighth and furthest. Furthest means far planet of the solar system. It is the fourth largest planet. This also appears blue, but it is not due to the presence of water, but due to the presence of methane gas. It revolves around the sun in 164 years. Here revolves means move in a circle. On its own axis, it rotates in 16 hours and 7 minutes. It has 8 satellites or moons around it. Next, we are going to learn about other celestial bodies. So what is mean by celestial bodies? Celestial body is a natural object which is located outside of Earth's atmosphere, such as the moon, the sun, an asteroid, planet or star. There are some other celestial bodies in the skies above us. These are the moons, the asteroids, the meteoroids and the comets. Next, let's see what is mean by satellite. Satellite is an object that orbits or circles around a bigger object. So there are two kinds of satellites. The first one is natural satellite and the second one is artificial satellite. natural satellite such as the moon orbiting the earth. Here orbiting means move in a circle. Next we have artificial satellite such as the International Space Station orbiting the earth. Here orbiting means move in a circle. Next we are going to learn about moons. These are satellites of the planets. They revolve around the planet in their own orbit. So what is mean by orbit? Orbit is a path used by a celestial body to revolve around another celestial body and continue to do so while the planet revolves around the sun. Mercury and Venus are the only planets which do not have any moons around them. There are other satellites which are man-made and sent to orbit around the Earth. Such satellites are called artificial satellites. Aryabhatta was the first satellite launched by India. This satellite was named after the great Indian astronomer Aryabhatta. It was launched through a Soyuz rocket on 19th April 1975. So, astronomers are scientists who study the universe, its objects, and how it works. Now, let's see about Earth's moon. The moon is the only natural satellite of the Earth. It has a diameter which is nearly 1/4 of the Earth's diameter. It appears very big, or nearly as large as the sun, as it is much closer to the Earth in comparison to the sun. It is about 384,000 kilometers from the Earth. The moon rotates around the Earth in 27 days and 8 hours, and it also takes the same time to spin on its axis. Spin means rotate on its axis. Axis means center line. It is because of this that the same side of the moon is visible from the Earth at all times. It has no light of its own but appears to shine because it reflects the light of the sun falling on it. Do you know, the USA had sent in the first human being on the surface of the moon. Neil Armstrong was the first astronaut to put his foot on the surface of the moon in July 1969. Who's an astronaut? Astronaut is a person who is trained to travel in a spacecraft. Then, life is not possible on the moon as it does not have any water or atmosphere of its own. Because of this, there are no clouds, rain, winds, etc. on the moon. The surface is open and rough. It has many ups and downs on its surface, and that is why you can see dark and bright patches on it when you see it at night, as it does not have any atmosphere. Sound cannot travel on the moon. It is the movement of the moon around the Earth that sometimes causes eclipses. You could have heard of this phenomenon many times and even seen it happening. So here phenomenon means wonder. So now we are going to learn about an eclipse. An eclipse takes place when one heavenly body such as a moon or planet moves into the shadow of another heavenly body. In other words, an eclipse takes place when Earth or the moon passes through a shadow. Here we can see the picture of an eclipse. Do you know, India had also sent a rocket called Chandrayaan the first with some instruments to the moon in 2008. and it became the fourth nation in the world to have sent something to the moon. Some instruments were sent to study the soil and search for water on the moon's surface. Next, we are going to learn about asteroids. Here we can see the picture of asteroids. Asteroids are small rocky celestial bodies moving around the sun between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Here, orbit means it is a path used by a celestial body to revolve around another celestial body. Scientists believe that they are remains of a planet which exploded many years ago. Here, scientist means experts or researchers believe that they are remains of a planet which exploded. Exploded means burst many years ago. Next, we are going to learn about meteoroids. Here we can see the picture of meteoroids. These are small rocky pieces which float freely around the sun in outer space. So, meteoroids are small rocky pieces which float freely around the sun in outer space. Sometimes they come close to the Earth's surface. While they enter the Earth's atmosphere, the friction with the atmosphere causes them to heat up and they burn out. Here, friction means it is a force that acts to stop the movement of two touching things. On occasions when the meteoroids do not burn out completely, they fall on the Earth and create a hollow. Hollow means having a hole or empty space inside on the Earth's surface. Now we are going to learn about comet. Here we can see the picture of comet. First, we have to know what is mean by comet. Comet is a celestial object consisting of a nucleus of ice and dust, and when near the sun, a trail of gas and dust particles away from the sun. In other words, a comet is an icy small solar system body that, when passing close to the sun, warms and begins to release gases, a process called outgassing. Comets are visible from Earth on rare occasions. These are a type of asteroid, but unlike asteroids, they are far away in outer space beyond the planets. They have a long shining tail which is formed by clumps of ice, gas and dust. Halley's Comet is one such comet which was seen in 1986 and which will be visible after 76 years. In India, it is also known as Poochal Tara, which means a star with a tail. It would be visible again in 2062. There are other comets also and may be visible at different times. I have enclosed the classbook instructions in the PDF. Kindly refer it. So now, we have reached the end of this session. Thank you.